And look at all that space we have here. You can see a wide space between the sulcus and the tooth structure itself. Sometimes you might even find a patient's car keys or a credit card they lost in there. That's, we're looking deeply into the sulcus and seeing what we can see. Now, as we look at this picture, let's backtrack a little bit. Let me remind you that if you remember from the prep module, the way the tooth core technique takes place as it integrates with the reverse preparation technique is that I break the contacts first and foremost. So if we're prepping a central incisor or a lower molar, we break the contacts, and then I take a double zero cord, so that the smallest one in the ultra-pack cords, that double zero cord, and we floss it into place, and then we pack it, we cut the two ends so that it's flush. So we have the double zero cord at the base of the sulcus, all the way down against the base of the sulcus. Now this accomplishes a couple of things. The first thing it accomplishes is vertical retraction of the tissue. So on a central incisor like this, when I put a double zero cord in, it retracts the tissue apically about a half to maybe two thirds of a millimeter, just based on the patient's gingiva and how deep the sulcus is and the attached gingiva and all that kind of stuff. So somewhere between a half and two thirds of a millimeter. Or if I do it on a lower molar, I put that double zero in and it retracts it again apically a half a millimeter to two thirds of a millimeter. So this is useful, this vertical retraction, because when I retract the sulcus vertically, I'm gonna be able to go in and prep at that free margin of the gingiva with my burr, with that round burr. And when I take that cord out, the tissue's gonna rebound, and now we're gonna have a restorative margin that's gonna be a half to two thirds of a millimeter subgingival, but I never had to take a burr subgingival, which will chew up the tissue, cause a lot of bleeding and stuff like that. So that initial cord does a good job of doing vertical retraction of the tissue, so I can now prep my margin at that gingival level, knowing it'll be subgingival when the cord's removed. The second thing it does is it acts as our Band-Aid. So we know the base of the sulcus is always inflamed on a patient. My teeth, your it doesn't matter whose mouth it is. You put a single cord in there, leave it in there for a few minutes, take it out, there will be bleeding. It's just the way it is. So this bottom cord, our double zero cord, in addition to giving us vertical retraction, is also gonna be our Band-Aid. So we can put another cord on top of it, the top cord in the two cord technique, and we can pull that out when we're getting ready to make the impression. And now there won't be any bleeding because the double zero cord, our Band-Aid, is still in place. So that's the second important function of that double zero cord. I mentioned the double zero cord. The first cord gets rid of the vertical retraction. It takes care of it, and it takes care of most of it, and that's good, because once we've dealt with the vertical retraction, we can now try to achieve what we're really after, which is horizontal retraction. We want to move the gingiva horizontally away from the tooth. That's what laboratory technicians want and crave and need to be able to see, is that horizontal retraction. But the only way to get horizontal retraction with a retraction cord is to have already placed a cord in to get rid of the vertical one. Because if you didn't put that double zero in first, let's say you went right to the two cord and put it in, it still rolls under the gingival cuff and gives you gingival retraction, and it's under the gingival cuff, that band of gingiva that's here, and the cord rolls underneath it. It's not until we put our double zero in and it's sitting there, we get the vertical retraction, and now we put a top cord in, the vertical retraction's already gone, where we now can get this lateral retraction of the tissue, because it moves in two dimensions. So we have to move it down before we can move it out. The only other way to do it is if we had like maybe a size 12 or some huge retraction cord that would do both things at once. You'd push it in, and assuming it didn't tear the tissue away from the underlying periosteum, you could get vertical and horizontal or lateral retraction of the tissue at the same time. That really doesn't happen very much though, as you know. This is the kind of impression that theoretically can lead to you having a crown that only has margins that are open 30 microns. I mentioned earlier that all crowns are designed with 30 micron openings at the margin to allow the cement to escape when we have the patient bite down on the crown. And that's absolutely true, but they get worse from there, you know, depending on how difficult it is to read the impression and therefore design the crown at the marginal area. And it can go up to 50 microns open, 100, 150, 200 microns open at the margin. And so to really get as good of a margin as we can get, this is the kind of impression that we need to be sending our laboratories. And it's not difficult to do. Is it more time? Yeah. Two cords takes more time than no cords, as you might expect. But is it worth it? Well, it's incredible. You can't miss that impression. You know, you're gonna be taking a polyvinyl gun and squirting it in just like this. And look at all that space we have here. You can see a wide space between the sulcus and the tooth structure itself. Sometimes you might even find a patient's car keys or a credit card they lost in there. That's, we're looking deeply into the sulcus and seeing what we can see.
Are you enjoying this instructional video? I hope so. If you'd like to receive additional clinical instruction with AGD and ADA approved CE credits, all at no charge, be sure to visit glidewelldental.com/education, where in addition to over 60 on-demand clinical courses, you can also access our weekly webinars along with other valuable content.